So let's see, we can pop this little folding stand out right here, and oh yeah. Hey Warenoticers, Shane here, and welcome to another video on the Warenotice Technology YouTube channel. If you're new here, definitely take a moment to consider subscribing so you don't miss out on all my other awesome technology videos about things like smartphones, smartwatches, cases, tech accessories, computers, tablets, and really just so much more. But anyway, folks, in this video, we're gonna be unboxing this guy right here. This is the Spigen Card Holder Smart MagSafe Folding Wallet. So that is definitely a mouthful, but basically what this guy allows you to do is attach this magnetic wallet that can hold up to 2 credit cards to the back of your iPhone. And it can also fold and become a stand for your phone. And that is something I'm super interested in checking out because there's definitely a lot of MagSafe wallets out there, but this one seems to do something just a little bit differently. So without further ado, let's get to getting this guy out of the box. Here we go. So folks, here we are up close and personal with this box. As you can see, it's pretty teeny. It says Spigen right here. It's got a picture here and here. It says up to 2 cards in it. And yeah, over here on the back, we got another picture of it as well as how you can push the card out through it. And voila, now we could just pop this box open right here. And here it is. Now the box is empty and we've got some paperwork right here. This is actually pretty interesting. It shows all the different ways you can use the folding stand right there. And here it is itself. So let's just open up this little plastic baggie right here. And wow, it's actually got some weight to it. It's got this cool material right here. I know it's not carbon fiber, but it sort of almost looks like it, maybe. And look at this, it's really flippity floppity. So according to that document, right here is magnetic, right here is magnetic, and right here is a metal plate. As you can see, this is sort of that folding stand right here. So we can just like fold it out, and then you could just prop your phone onto it just like that. Then also, if you're wondering, you can use these slots to slip your credit cards in, and over here is that little hole that you can use to push them out. So yeah, you know what? Let's get this on my iPhone 12 Pro Max. So we've got the 12 Pro Max and we got the Spigen Magnetic MagSafe Wallet. We can just slap it on right there and it does feel like it wants to move around quite a bit right there. So yeah, if I'm very light with it, it doesn't, but if I apply a little bit of pressure, it definitely does. So let's see, we can pop this little folding stand out right here, and oh yeah. So you know what, I'm actually going to put a case on my iPhone and see if it feels more solid like that, because I've noticed with other magnetic MagSafe accessories, sometimes they can feel more solid with a case on. So right here first, I'll put on Spigen's very own clear MagSafe case. It's pretty fitting to use their case and their wallet at the same time, right? So now this is on right here and we can grab the wallet and then we can slap it on. And let's see, yeah, that definitely feels more solid right there. But if I do apply a certain amount of pressure, it still will move right there. And now with this flippity flap right here, if we put it in position to make it into the stand, I'm noticing one thing when we put it down on the table, especially with my big 12 Pro Max right here, it feels very top heavy, like it wants to fall over right there. So that is definitely something to note. That is weird, because in the pictures, it is standing with this stand, but no, mine does not want to stand up. Maybe it's just because I have the biggest iPhone, but that definitely stinks right there. But now this is weird. So look, when I put the stand like this to hold my phone horizontally and then I put it on the table, it actually does stand up. Again, it is very wobbly, so the slightest touch will make it want to fall over, but it actually does stand. So that is interesting. That is weird that it's almost like it's better standing horizontally, which I feel like it would be worse at. But again, one little tap and it will fall over. So that definitely stinks right there. The stand was not as good as I thought it would be on this case, but hey, what do you expect? This is a $40 magnetic wallet right here. So it is cheaper than Apple's own MagSafe wallet. But it definitely stinks the stand. What makes it different doesn't seem very good, at least based on my personal impressions. Anyway though, now let's try a non-Spigen case with this wallet. Obviously it should work because once again, MagSafe compatible. So here we've got the Mouse Bamboo Limitless 4.0 case. I just unboxed this. You should check out that video as well. And let's see, slap it on and yup, it works with this too. Feels like, yeah, I mean, it feels solid, but it definitely, if you give it a little force, it wants to move around. And last but not least, I'm also going to try this on Apple's clear MagSafe case. So now I have that on my iPhone right here and we can slap this Spigen on. And yeah, pretty much the same thing. It feels maybe a little more solid. I don't really know. But yeah, that flap is just kind of funny. This is pretty satisfying though when it like clicks on just like that. Oh yeah. So now I've got the Spigen case back on my phone with the Spigen wallet as well. And let's actually try putting a credit card inside of this magnetic wallet. You know what? I'm actually gonna put the card in with the wallet, not on my phone. That's probably what's gonna be what's easiest. And there it is in that. And then we can put the wallet back on the phone. And as you can see, the Apple card is in there. So that's pretty cool. Now let's try to figure out how to get it out. So with the wallet not on my phone, I've been trying to shimmy it through with this little area right here, the sort of hole, but that isn't really doing anything. So maybe I should just grab it and then, yeah, whatever. I guess I can just pull it out like that. But I guess if you have this, you're probably going to want to take the wallet off your phone to put the card in and take it out. It seems like that is what is easiest. Anyway, with that, there's not really much more to say about this MagSafe wallet right here. If you want it for yourself, it'll set you back about $40. And definitely let me know down in the comments what you think of it. Do you love it? Do you hate it? Do you have it for yourself? Let me know, because I do love hearing from you guys. And if you enjoyed this video, definitely be sure to smash that subscribe button and subscribe to the Warenotice Technology YouTube channel for more awesome technology videos just like this one. And down in the description, I'm going to have a link to my playlist of all my MagSafe accessory videos if you're in the market for some of those, including this one right here. And I'll also have a link to my playlist of all my iPhone 12 Pro Max case unboxings down there as well if you want to check that out too. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and thank you so much for subscribing. Bye.